Hi, it's Stacye, and welcome to another Stacye Monday Morsel. I hope that you're doing well. Anyway, diving right in. So, we have doggy visitors today, by the way. So, if you see me moving about, it's because I have puppies with me. But anyway, so, diving in. Tonight's topic is called Understanding, A Misunderstanding. And the thing about misunderstandings is if you ever pay attention, we either don't understand one another, we don't understand why someone has done something or said something to us, and especially in couples, in relationships, we don't understand why someone behaves or says a certain thing. And here's the thing, what we forget, what each of us forgets, whether it's your friend, your lover, or your family, well, not your family so much, but definitely friends and lovers, is that we have all been raised differently. We all grew up with different sets of people in different social situations, different economic situations, and so therefore we have different manners and different things that are acceptable or not acceptable. And so a lot of times when we have misunderstandings, it's really because we're different and we forget that we're different. We forget that we each have something, a different background, the different things that we've learned. We also do something that I've absolutely never understood. When we disagree, we don't know how to just disagree and be open-minded to learning something new. But we need to disagree and belittle someone else's thought process, their opinion, the way they feel about something, without realizing we're not being very nice or loving or kind to someone that we're supposed to care about. It's okay to have disagreements because none of us are alike and we all have our opinions. But here's the thing, we're all entitled to our opinions. And there isn't necessarily a right or a wrong, there's just different. And I think that's one of the things, one of the biggest mistakes that we've all been taught is there has to be a right and a wrong when sometimes it's not about that. It is really just about different. A different way of looking at the world, different experiences, different beliefs. And no one way is necessarily right. It may be right for you, but it doesn't mean that it's right for everyone else. And what kind of brought this up is just listening to, you know, we're in election season, so the disagreements and the way people feel about some of the issues that have, the more serious issues that have gone on in the world that I don't want to give too much energy to. And it all comes down to a big misunderstanding and us not necessarily respecting each other's point of view. But as I said, going back to couples, it comes down to us being raised by different parents and different households, seeing different examples of things, seeing different examples of how relationships are conducted, different ways that children are raised. Now, when you're in a relationship, the difference is you have to build your own language and find what works for both of you. And I think we forget that. And again, no way is right or wrong. They're just different. And so you have to figure out how to merge the two worlds and not with conflict, but with love. Because there's so much out there to learn if we would just be open-minded to the fact that there are things that are different than what we've experienced or different than what we know, and be open to learning new and different things. Because there may be something that someone does that is different, but it really is easier, faster, better, smarter, more money-making, whatever, if you're just open to having the experience. So there's nothing wrong, there's no right or wrong. It's just about understanding that things are different. You don't have to embrace all that's different, but you have to be open to understanding different so that there are not misunderstandings. To be clear, not only do we just disagree with people, but that need to be right and they have to be wrong and the belittling of someone's opinion is not necessary. It could just be you learning something. Because if you weren't so busy trying to browbeat somebody into thinking like you and understanding your point and hearing you, you might learn something.
Oh, think of that.
So it is about being open so that when we don't agree, it doesn't turn into a war. You know, going to the war phase of it, that's the other thing that we do that I've never understood. Why is it when we're in conflict or have a disagreement with someone, especially someone we love, we're in a relationship with, the first person might have said something or done something completely unconsciously. Didn't know, just did it. Maybe they did it with somebody else, didn't seem like it was a big deal, whatever. And now we've taken it personally. You know, they've done something. And so we can't just correct them kindly with love and say, you know, I really appreciate you didn't do that, or that kind of hurt my feelings, or whatever it is we need to say. But no, we go into combat mode and we pull out of our arsenal the most hurtful thing because they've hurt us. We feel we need to hurt them. But here's the thing, what they did was unconscious. What you're doing is consciously hurting somebody. And the thing we forget is you can't take words back. You can't make them go away. It's unlike, you know, every one of us at some point or another, your parents spanked you. None of us remember the spanking. It was something that happened. We knew we did wrong. We were corrected. We moved on. But when someone says something to you that hurts your feelings, especially someone that you love and care about, you will hear those words for the rest of your life. They echo every time there's a disagreement. Because now you know this person that you've given your heart to, that you've trusted, that you thought had your back, will hurt you. Changes the dynamics of a relationship and people don't even realize it. They don't realize that they're putting the cracks in the plate themselves. When honestly all you have to do is say, yeah, please, I really wish you wouldn't do that. That hurt my feelings. Those simple little terms, simple phrases, can change everything. Instead of, you know, that time you did X, Y, Z, and you did blah, 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 you, whatever, because I can think of a whole bunch of things. And of course, we say it in a pitch that's unkind, and all because we had a misunderstanding. All because someone might have stepped out of their lane and did something that maybe they shouldn't have done, that they may have done unintentionally. So when something disturbs you, or bothers you, it's not always about revving up and going to 10. Sometimes you have to take a breath and try to understand the other person's point of view, or maybe put yourself in the person's shoes to understand, well, maybe that's how they were raised. Maybe that's what they were taught. It doesn't make it right or wrong. We just each have our own way. Anyway, this is Stacie. Tell me what you think about that. Love to hear what you got to say. I hope you'll join me next week for another Stacie Monday morsel. And also, if you like this video, please be sure to like it. Join me on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, blah, 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 all the social sites. And I will see you next week. Love and blessings. Bye-bye.